which is probably not the smartest thing to do. So investigation has been started. Good. We did it, Boyd. We won. That Ernest really knows a lot about shooting, even taught us a thing or two. He invited us out hunting to celebrate the victory, so we'll be taking the day off. We deserve it. Damn. Unbelievable. Okay, so let's open the investigation. Still a guy. There. Okay. So I'm going to say that, that, and that. There we go. Suspect is Kuan Yin Lin, Chinese immigrant recently expelled from the university. I don't even think we need our best officers for that. Oh, fuck! I'm not gonna... Am I gonna be able to? Oh! A guard went out for a smoke and saw a teenager writing obscenities on the wall of the building. I chased the brat up the tree. You can take it from here. Okay, so we're just gonna send one officer because I don't think we need multiple for that. End of the day! The offender was caught. And we have one left. Honestly, you don't even... Okay, so... Aw, and he escaped. Looks like tomorrow is going to be a long day. More like the first of a lot of long days. There's just too much going on. So it's interesting how you go by it through each and every fucking day. Thomas Blaine, pregnant woman killer sent to mental hospital. According to Dr. Eleonora Waterbury, Thomas Blaine has a new form of schizophrenia. Mayor Rogers is not afraid of the competition. Oh, that was funny.
Mr. Boyd, there was a man here earlier. He left you this.
A man? What man? Who let him on this floor?
I don't know. I've never seen him before. I asked him his name, but he just ignored me. He was talking on a big telephone, you know, one of those portables. He gave me this envelope and left.
Damn. Okay, let's see about this. Of course, they could have shot them the second they took the photo. But I knew Kendrick and his family were all right. Either way, the message was not that they got out. It meant that I was in. My servitude to the Mafia had begun. I'd only been in my new position 5 seconds, and I already knew why Kendrick called it a contract. You sound doomed if you call it what it is. A curse. Boyd.
Good morning, Jack. I believe you just received my message.
Who am I speaking with?
Oh, I'm sorry. I forget some people don't recognize my voice. But I assure you, Jack, if I was sitting right there in front of you, you'd have no trouble recognizing me. Like I was a member of your family. Even better than a wife, perhaps. A wife can betray you. No man is immune.
I don't talk to people who don't tell me their names.
Oh, Jack, don't be so childish. You're too old to run away from strangers. Yes, we both are. And in our old age, friendship becomes rare and all the more precious. But of course, we must work with new people and find out new names. So if you insist, Jack, let us formally meet. Hello, Jack Boyd. I'm Christopher Sand.
Wonderful, Mr. Sand. And what is it you do for a living?
Oh, you'll soon find out all about that. Well, you'll learn much more than a simple policeman could ever expect. You're a simple policeman no longer, Jack. Don't turn off your phone. You start today.
Eight in ten. It's been my go-to principle since my first day on the job. I've got to let my colleagues hush up what they need to, 2 out of 10 times, so that they'll help me with the remaining 8. 80 out of 100, 800 out of 1,000, I'm proud of those statistics. It's not so bad for Freeburg, right? But now I just officially became a mafia whore. I'm supposed to be fearing for my life, for the lives of my wife and children, but the only thing I can think, what's gonna happen to 8 and 10?
Alright. I was up all night reading an exciting detective story called The Last Temptation of Neptune, but I don't have time to get to the ending. I'm almost certain that the killer is Commissioner Harold, but I can't rest until I know for sure. Can I go home and finish reading the book? No! Trust me, if I could take the day off to just fucking play video games, I would, but... you know, we all have things we have to do. Alright, I prefer this one. So this is the B shift. Bunny Lin turned out to be a member of the gang known as the Red Masks. He could help you take down the gang if you make him an informant, except there are a number of gangs in Freeburg, and that means there's bounties to collect. Some of the criminals you come across will be members of one gang or another. In exchange for immunity, they may be willing to give up their bosses. Let's start to investigate. In the way you can get your hooks into gang members higher and higher up the food chain and ultimately take down the boss. If you do arrest the boss, the gang will be finished and you'll claim a higher reward. There is also a reward for formally charging gang members. Whenever you arrest a gang member, you get a bonus, but your deal with that person is over. Don't settle for small fish. Use the small fish to catch the big fish. No, we're not gonna arrest him. I didn't want to arrest him, but I guess I have no choice. Let's go. And since this is a gang, let's go ahead and put 3 people on. Mao Liang gave several interviews in which she spoke about atrocities committed by the Red Masks gang. She embellished a lot and distorted the facts. If you want to keep people from panicking, you'll need to take down the gang within the next 4 days. Jack, you swore an oath to serve the city. If you can't keep your promises, we won't keep ours. SWAT upgrade. Now you can improve your SWAT team. Yay! Increase efficiency. We'll work. We'll work 2 times a day. All right. Let's deal with petty squabbles and the occasional violent crime. A young employee at the factory got into a fight with the manager and is trying to push him into a vat of boiling chocolate. We're gonna send our most professional and our least professional. Ooh, the investigation has started. All right. This is riveting content, isn't it? I mean, just look at that screen with, you know, the flashing lights. Okay, finally. Parking lot attendant Dylan Burns reports seeing a teenager walking between cars trying handles in hopes of finding an unlocked vehicle. Before the attendant could approach him, the teenager found an unlocked door and shut himself inside. A few seconds later, the teen drove shrieking from the parking lot, greatly exceeding the speed limit. He fled towards the suburbs. Well, I don't know. I don't trust this kid. We're gonna send all three. There's just something dangerous about someone driving around a stolen vehicle. Cause I don't know. I get like panicked, you know, vehicular homicide vibes from that. Officers have determined the car thief's location. Overtake the criminal and attempt to take him into custody. Overtake the offender and block the road. Catch up with the stolen vehicle and open fire. We're gonna block the road. Damn! A weeping child called in saying that someone was holding him against his will. They won't let me go outside. They torture me and bully me. I don't think I can keep going. I want to go outside and see Pete. I actually remember this one, and the kid like just wouldn't eat his vegetables. So we're gonna send two of our lower ranking officers just in case like it's an actual kidnapping case. Because I don't know if there's a level of, like, randomness to this game. And there we go. And other than those two, I now have a full roster. So, it's okay. We received a call from an angry casino patron. He claims that one of the casino girls that was hanging around his table lifted his wallet, which was carrying a couple thousand dollars in cash and several credit cards. Casino security shoved him outside, saying he was drunk, but the man isn't giving up so easily. We're gonna send a highly competent officer down. Jack, we're dealing with a moron who refuses to repay his debts. Says that the police will protect him. I think it's time we show him whose side the police are on. Oh god, I don't want to do this. But I will. Joseph Lowry's mother wouldn't let him go play until he ate his broccoli. I was right. How's our investigation going? Oh, wait. Reopen the case. Shit. Oh, good job. Oh dear. At a parking lot exit, a security guard stopped a suspicious-looking van and asked to check the driver's membership card. The female driver reached casually into the glove compartment and pulled out a gun and opened fire. We're sending as many people as we can. Once a gun's involved, and a police cruiser has caught up with the perpetrator's van. Shoot out the tires. Use the bullhorn to order the van to stop. They're not gonna fucking stop. Try to run the van off the road. The van takes a sharp turn and crashes through the window of a sex shop. A woman exits the vehicle, grabs the shop attendant, and points a gun to his head. Let go of the man right now. Shoot the criminal in the head. Throw a rubber sex. But I get the feeling that throwing a rubber sex off the assailant is a bad idea. Oh! No one was hurt! How? How the fuck did that happen? I thought for sure someone was gonna die regardless of what I did. I am very happy now. Thank you. And is that it? Can I... Oh, let's open the investigation. Alright, so... it's that, that, and that. Okay, so... nope, okay. So let's go back and was that what I did the first time? Wait, so maybe it's locking. Okay, there's only so many ways that we can arrange this. So, let's do this in an orderly fashion. So we have this, these three, that didn't work. We have that, 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 that didn't work. And I think that's the only combination we can do there. So we'll put that, that, that. Oh, there we go. Ning He, Chinese immigrant, hasn't officially worked anywhere in the past 10 years.